it is bounded by 0 and 1 because it's probability. And when we sum them up, we should end up with 1. For this for continuous case, I will use same f of x. You can change it if you want. We are using probability density function. So because in discrete case, each f of x value, lowercase x, so they represents number, it gives us probability. So we know what is the chance that we can observe that small numerical value. But in continuous case, we don't have the probabilities. We have the density. Okay. So what is the density at that point is very important. And we have two rules to be a probability density function. Okay, so let's think about like that. Actually, it's not a probability. So only rule is that it should be bounded by zero. And when we integrate it from whole real line, f of x dx should be one. Okay, so these are the two rules. So you can see the difference between PMF and PDF. Okay, so when we consider the probability density function, maybe you can understand it this way easily. Sometimes you have some confusion. Okay, so let's say we have a positive random variable ranging from 0 to infinity, and it takes some values like 0.1, 0.2, blah, 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 let's say 5, and goes like that. And let's say, so how frequent we are observing 0.1 compared to all observations that we have. Let's say this much. Okay, so this gives us the density at 0.1. And similarly, let's say at 0.2 we have this value. So this gives us the density at that point. How frequent I'm seeing 0.2 in my sample or in my population actually. Okay, and let's say this is the most frequent one. We observe it like that, and then we have f of 5 here. Then when we combine all these things, let's say, so let's say we observe such a shape. Okay, so each small value basically infinitely many numbers, so we have the mass at each point, so we can see how frequent they are. For example, this quantity 0.01, let's say, so it is not that frequent. Also these quantities are not that frequent, but we can see that we may observe 5 a lot in our sample. Okay, so it is the mass. It can be greater than 0, but the most important thing here is that the area under this curve should be 1. Okay, so we should end up with 1. Okay, so this is the difference between continuous and discrete case. Another tool that we are using a lot is the cumulative distribution function. You know the formula and how to find it. I will not give them it in detail. Yeah, but cumulative distribution function and also moment generating function, we are using them a lot because when we have probability density function or mass function, we can observe two same mathematical form of two different distributions actually. But cumulative distribution function and moment generating function are unique to each distribution. So each distribution has unique CDF and unique PDF. Okay, so to be able to characterize a distribution, we prefer to use cumulative distribution function or the moment generating function. Okay, so then the characteristics of a random variable, let's summarize these also. Most important thing is the expected value. And by using expected values, basically we can generate moments, which gives us the whole characteristics of a distribution. So if we know the moments of a random variable, then we can have any type of information that we need to know. Location, variability, skewness, kurtosis, or other things. Okay? So expected value in statistics is very important. Regular expectation, actually expected value of a random variable, is just the weighted average of random variables where weights are PDFs, PDF or PMF values for that specific x value. Okay, so when we consider expectation of x here, then let's say for discrete case, for continuous case, just replace summation by integral sign, x and under the whole event space x times f of x. Okay, so these are the weights, these are the random variables. If the the probability value or the PDF value is too much, then the weight of that random variable will be high. For example, when we consider 5 years, as you can see, the value, the weight of that will be higher. So what we expect is, we expect to get closer values to 5. For example, when we have this shape of random variable probability density function, so I expect to have its mean value around here. It will be close to 5. Okay, then actually if you want to find any other expectations, any function of x, we can use g of x. It could be x square, ln x or other things. So all we have to change is these x to that function, x square, whatever that is. And one rule on the expectation to be exist, this expectation exists if and only if expected value of the absolute x is finite. Okay, so if this is finite, then expected x will be finite. All you need to check for the existence is this one. We will not use this information, specific information in the class. Okay, and expectation is a linear operator, you know. For example, when we have a linear equation like that, then when we consider the expectation of y, we will end up with these actually. So very easily we can get the, using the expectation of x, we can find the expectation of y for a linear function. Okay, so moments are very important, as I told you before. So it gives us all characteristics of the distribution. So mostly used ones are the first four moments, central moments, or the functions that are used for using the first four moments. So these characterize the whole distribution. But if we know the several moments, like the 100th moment, 1000th moment, millionth moment, so it gives us little by little some information related to the characteristic of a distribution. For some distributions, only two of the moments are enough to be able to characterize the whole distribution. But for some others, more moments will be needed. Okay, when we consider the mean, so it is the expected value or just the mu. Okay, so it gives us information about the location of a random variable. About the location of a random variable, how most of the observations are located. For example, for this case, we can see that it's around 5. But we have a symmetric. If we have a symmetric distribution, so we know that most of the observations accumulated at the center. So this is the location of the random variable, mu. Okay, so variance, another important tool that we are using. So what is the deviation of the random variable from its mean? So it is a measure of variability or spread of a random variable around its mean. So how the variation is changing, for example, we have this type of thing or this type of thing. So here mu values are the same, but the variations are different. So here, for example, here the variation is this much, but for the same, for the other distribution, it is this much. So variation is higher in the yellow one. So this means that many observations are varied a lot. So we have different type of observations. But if the variance is low, small, then what we see here, let's say this is the mu value. So most of the observations are around mu. So when we have a sample, basically we will know that most of the observations will be around mu. Okay, so we will not expect these small numbers. See, the chance that we will get, the likelihood that we will get these numbers are very low. But it's more, not most likely to get mu or around mu values. But for the yellow distribution, let's say, so they are varied a lot. As you can see, the chance, the likelihood that these quantities are much more higher than the other one. So we will not be sure that our sample has values very close to mu value because of the variation. So we might have observations here, here, here. So we will not be sure about that if the variation is high. So we prefer to have a small variance because of that. To be able to talk about the same units, we are using standard deviations, you know, sigma, just the square root of variance. Because when we are talking about meters, in mean we are observing mean in terms of meters. In variance, it will be meter square. But for using the, but if we use the standard deviation, then the unit that we are talking about, it will be again meters. So we will prefer to talk on the same units most of the time. So other things actually, That's very important. So these are two basic moments, the central moment or regular moment. Other tools that we are using a lot is the skewness. So it uses first three moments to be able to calculate it. So it is the measure of lack of symmetry. So third central moment over the second central moment over 3 over 2. So it measures the lack of symmetry. So when skewness is zero, so we have a symmetric distribution like normal, right? So it's not my drawing is not like symmetric, but assume it's symmetric. Okay, so if it is negative, then we have a negatively skewed, or instead of negative we use left skewed shape, so we will have this type of distribution. Or when it is positive, then we have a positively skewed shape, so this is right skewed, and many distributions that we know actually right skewed, like exponential gamma chi square, Weibull, many of them symmetric or right skewed like that. Okay, so with skewness, you can see what type of distribution you have. Okay, so most of the statistical tools derive for normal distribution. So if your sample has skewness around zero, so okay, you can say that, okay, I have a symmetric distribution at least. Okay, another tool is very important also, using the first four moments, is the kurtosis, which is the fourth central moment over the square of the second central moment. So it measures the peakedness of the random variable. Actually, it is defined by the kurtosis of normal distribution. Kurtosis of normal distribution is 3 for normal. Okay, so it can be greater than 3 or less than 3. So if it is greater than 3, most of the financial series having the kurtosis greater than 3, so they are known as leptokurtic. So if normal is something like that, then these are heavy tailed distributions like that. Okay, so we have heavy tails, or platykurtic. So these are like so we don't see these in real life examples that much. Another tool is the excess kurtosis. Maybe you heard about these. Excess kurtosis, which is kurtosis minus 3. So for normal, this excess kurtosis equals to 0. And Excel, when you look at Excel, actually, so when you want to get the kurtosis, it gives you excess kurtosis, actually. Okay, so if you are getting 0, it's good. So if this both skewness and kurtosis are 0, so this means that you might have a normal distribution. One of the well-known normality tests, which is known as Jarque-Barre normality test, economists use a lot for time series data, Barre normality test. So it based on the hypothesis that both skewness and excess kurtosis equals to 0. So if this is the case, if we cannot reject this null hypothesis, we can say that our data is following normal distribution. Okay, so this is the one test that are that is used for informal normality. It's a kind of weak because it's based just based on the moments, like third and fourth moments. But it is well known and used normality test. It's not powerful like powerful like Shapiro-Wilk test. Another tool that we will use to be able to find the distributions is moment generating functions. So this core at the beginning of the semester we will use this because it helps us a lot. Actually, it's much more easy to use this way instead of using the Jacobian transformation, so MGF. It's the special type of expectation, actually, expectation of e to the t x, where t is defined on some neighborhood of h. And it has good properties, actually. We will use some of them. For example, MGF of y, which is a plus bx. If we know the MGF of x, then we can easily find the MGF of y. Basically, you don't have to memorize this. Just using this expectation formula, you can derive this formula by yourself. X bt. Okay. Another thing, when we have a random sample, let's say x1 to xn random sample, we will use this a lot. When we consider MGF of y, which is summation of these. Okay, then the moment generating function of this will be the multiplication of, we don't have to say I because they are identical. Let me erase I. Because they are identical, they all have the same moment generating function. So it is the nth power of the x MGF of x. Okay, so these are some easiness of the moment generating functions that we will use. You have to also remember functions of random variables, Jacobian method, or other methods like CDF method to find distributions. But I think most important one and that mostly used one will be the help of moment generating functions. Moment generating functions. Oops. Still. Generating functions. Okay. Okay. So we will use this. Okay. So let me stop here and be ready for the second video. Thank you.